I just want to start by saying that the dude that took your shirt off, I want you to know I hate you with my whole body. I got so mad when this took his shirt off, I started throwing back there. That was me making all that noise. I can't stand no extra fine ass. I don't like that shit. What is you still working out for? Why is you still going? You done. What is finished? What's complete? I go to the gym, you know what I'm saying? This ain't part of the show, but little runts like me can't go work out, you know what I'm saying? Because they make us feel like we inferior when we get to the gym. I was in there, and it was a dude just like Blue working out, and I asked him, so I said, sir, why are you still coming here? Apparently, you didn't finish. I'm like, do you think you're gonna get into it with a tree or a shark or something? Like, what are you preparing for? He was like, yeah, just in case I gotta move some stuff around. I'm like, that up in Spanish. Don't quote me on that, I think. My Spanish is a little rusty. I was in the back watching the news. How lame is Ray J? He's still claiming somebody he had sex with 10 years ago, and he's still out making money off of that little bit of sex tape. And he told a woman that he's gonna donate her, his proceeds to him and Kanye like they need his money. And he ain't got no damn money. He made a song called I Hit It First, and that was the only problem I had, because we talking about Kim Kardashian, and I mean, come on, let's be real. He must have meant I hit it 100 at first, because first, he wasn't even first that day. He should have wrote a song about Whitney Houston called I Hit It Last. Michael Sam is this gay football player that they had kissing on ESPN. That just disgusted me. Hold on, let me start by saying this. I don't have no problem with gay people. I don't need y'all protesting, boycotting me. You know, I know they got a very powerful gay lobby here in Dallas. I don't have no problem with gay people. Some of my best friends are going to hell. Don't owe me, that's in the Bible. I don't know the chapter and the verse, but it's in the red words. And Donald Sterling can't stay out off the news. I'm so sick of hearing about him too. I actually feel sorry for the guy, because in reality he actually jealous of Magic Johnson. And guess what? I'm jealous of Magic Johnson too. I met Magic Johnson in LA one time, and I asked Magic, how in the hell are you getting fatter on AIDS? How you manage to do that? He got fatter and richer on AIDS. Diseases work backwards. I told him he catch cancer, his hair might grow back. What else are you talking about? Oh, this damn Beyonce and Solange thing. I'm not going to discuss that because I want to marry Beyonce and I'm going to put that on the record. I'm in love with that woman. As soon as I meet her, on her ass, I'm going to go. You hear me? It's gonna be a rape charge. I love that woman. She looked like she smelled like heaven. I'll fuck Jay-Z if she was next. That's how much I like her like that. Judge me all you want. Tiger Woods and what was that, Florida, and I hate Tiger Woods got divorced because in my opinion he ain't cheat on his wife at all and he should still be at home with his kids. You know what I'm saying? You heard what I said. Tiger Woods didn't cheat on his wife at all. He should still be at home with his wife and kids. I explain myself. Sir, yeah, in my opinion. But sir, you and I, in the scheme of things, right, we ain't nothing, to be honest with you. You know what I'm saying? In the scheme of things, you know what I'm saying? So if five women won't sleep with us, and we sleep with 4 out of 5 of them, then that means you slept with way too many women, okay? That puts you at 80%. You a whore if you sleep with 80% of the women that's gonna sleep with you. Well, Tiger slept with 14 women, but it's a million gonna sleep with him. So if we do the math on that, Tiger Woods cheated on his wife 0.00000012% of the time. Round up, that's a zero. What these just want from it? Somebody let me know. 0%? That's simple math. You can shake your head all you want, man. If a million people won't sleep with that man and he don't fuck 14, that means he love you. Checkpoints and sobriety checkpoint. Well, I'm from, if you're driving home drunk and you get home, that means you won. And apparently you weren't that drunk, you know what I'm saying? I was leaving Onyx drunk as a skunk and I pulled right into one of y'all sobriety checkpoints. As soon as I rolled my window down, police officer asked me, "Where you headed, buddy?" I said, "To jail." Y'all have here in Dallas that I just found out about. Y'all got a sperm bank here in Dallas. I didn't know what a sperm bank was. My manager had to explain the whole concept to me. Well, apparently, if you get down on your luck here, y'all got a building that you can go to and boogie, make a deposit, and then they'll pay you for it. And I've been out here just giving it away. When I found out that y'all was paying for jizz in Dallas, I called my mom and told her, "You ain't got to work no more. You quit that job, mom, because I found the lick." They told me for the weekend, but early Monday morning, you didn't come and be to this show to give out. I got a towel in my hotel room right now worth $4,000. I ain't been here for 3 days. You do the math. I'm a traveling comic, I get me. I ain't got a lie to you. I do. I'm in love with myself too. I turn myself on. I had to stop watching that porn. I ain't got addicted to that. I don't know how Kurt Franklin knew he was addicted, but I knew immediately. One time I pulled up to my house and before I opened the door, I spit on the lock, then put the key in. I said,